Welcome back, students. In the previous class, we had discussed two phyla, right? Under which the first one was the phylum Porifera and the other one the phylum Coelenterata, right? So, in this class, now we shall discuss the third phylum under the your syllabus, that is the phylum Ctenophora. Ctenophora are also called comb jellies. So, that is a common name for the phylum Ctenophora, like that in the phylum Coelenterata, which was called Nidiates, right? So similarly, here we call this phylum that is the comb jellies. I will just explain what the reason behind the name, common name, right? So here, this comb jellies, they are, when we speak about the habit and habitat, these are exclusively marine and they are free living and they are marine. So all the forms of this phyla, they are exclusively marine. There is no freshwater forms and these are purely aquatic forms with the marine habit, right? So now, the talking about the symmetry, as in case of the phylum Coelenterata, even here you find the radially symmetrical body, right? So here, as in the case of phylum Coelenterata, even here you find the radially symmetrical configuration, right? So that is, the body can be cut into two equal halves at any of the planes. Understood? So that is the radial symmetry. And then here, the level of organization, that is the tissue. That is, each of the functions that is carried out by different types of tissues, such as the digestive system or digestion, respiration, and the reproduction, etc. All these are brought about by the different types of tissues. So this is a little advanced than that of the phylum Porifera. Even in the Coelenterata, we find the tissue level of organization, right? So another, the special character of this phylum, there is a presence of 8 rows of ciliated comb plates. As we observe in this diagram, here we represent only 2 such scales, right? So similarly, we find there are 8 such scales, and that is why they are commonly called the comb jellies. Understood? Because of the presence of this comb plates, hence they are called the comb jellies, since the body is soft and jelly in structure. And here the characteristic of this comb plate, that is, they are 8 in number, that is 8 rows which are external and they are ciliated, that is, they have numerous hair like structure on the outer surface. As we studied in the phylum, when we studied the classification system, right, there we studied about the phylum Protista, right, where you find different cilia, that is the phylum protozoans, that is your the paramecium, ciliated protozoans. Similarly, even here you find numerous hair like structure on the outer surface, which is said to be the comb plates, right? Hence, that is commonly called comb jellies. Understood the point? So that is the characteristic feature of the phylum Ctenophora that you have to mention whenever you write the answer for the exams, right? The other one, that is another exclusive feature that is observed in the case of the Ctenophoras, that is the bioluminescence, that is the emission of the light by living organisms. So here, if it is an organism in the presence of light, they absorb the light of different wavelength and they emit the another set of light. So that is what we call the bioluminescence. So here, even here, the term that is bio refers to living, luminescence refers to the production of light. Clear? So that is meant by the bioluminescence. So this is another typical character of the phylum Ctenophora, the bioluminescence and the presence of 8 rows of this ciliated comb plates. So that is you have to, so these are the characters you have to mention whenever you write the important characteristics of this phylum. And when we speak about the reproduction, here the sexes, that is the both the organisms, they are unisexual, that is both the male and the female, that is separate, understood? So that is the males and females are different, hence they are called the unisexual forms. And then here the reproduction is exclusively sexual type, there is no fragmentation or any other means of reproduction, asexual reproduction, understood? So this is characteristically, that is we find that there is a sexual reproduction only, there is no other means of reproduction. So when we write the organisms, they are unisexual, that is the male and female members are different. And then the reproduction, that is sexual only, and that is the fertilization that takes place in the water, that is the external environment. Clear? So the fertilization, that is said to be external, so outside the animal body, hence we call this as external fertilization. And then here the development, that is the development meaning the conversion of the embryo into an adult, that is indirect. So there is a presence of embryo or what is called the larva. Larval forms are present and the younger ones, they doesn't look like the parents, or what we can say is they are distinct from their parents in the younger stages. Clear? So the development is what is called indirect type. And then here one of the examples for such kind of the phylum or the phylum Ctenophora, that is the Pleuroblachia. So this is an marine organism with two, that is actually there are 8, but here we show only 2, right? So there are 8 such comb plates covering the entire body. So these help in locomotion since there is presence of cilia, as well as this also helps in capturing of the food and protection from the prey or the predators, right? Then here there you find the numerous striations on the outer surface. Clear? So that is the example for the phylum Ctenophora, that is Pleuroblachia. So if you have any doubts, you can clarify. So now before ending this session, we shall just recall the important characteristics of this phylum, right? So this phylum, that is the phylum Ctenophora, that is commonly called comb jellies, and then they are exclusively marine in habitat, which are usually free living. Then the symmetry, talking about the symmetry, that is radially symmetrical, and they are triploblastic in nature. Understood. That is, they possess three layers of the body tissues. That is, outer ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. And then you find there is a tissue level of this organization. And we find eight rows of ciliated comb plates that are present outside the body. Hence, they are called the comb cilia. Clear? Now, another characteristic feature, that is the bioluminescence, wherein the organisms belonging to this phylum, they possess a special feature wherein the light is illuminated from their body. And then the animals, they are unisexual in nature, that is, the male and the female, they are different. Morphologically, they are different. And then, while speaking about the reproduction, that is by means of only sexual type. And then the fertilization, that is external, and the development, that is indirect, that is in the presence of the larva, which looks dissimilar to that of the adult. Understood? So that is the general characteristics of this phylum, the phylum Ctenophora. So if you have any doubts or clarifications, you can approach. So this is the third phylum. So in the next class, we shall now discuss the next phylum, that is the phylum Platyhelminthes, Ascomanthes, and the annelids. Right. So thank you.